Yeah, whatever.
This is nothing really to do with the show, except I thought it was entertaining. Susan, what is one of the tricks that you can do because of your height?
I can stand up completely straight in the back of a black cab.
Yes. So... I thought we'd see if you can fit in a pillar box. I just want to see if you can stand up inside a pillow. I'm way too tall. Can you fit in there?
I'm standing up completely straight.
Oh, that's right. There we go. Right, carrying on.
You've got to get in one of those and just do it. That would be a bit very, very funny candid camera, oh wouldn't God. It?
Okay, so here's my question.
Could I...
What would happen if you posted yourself to number 10 Downing Street? I let you out now. You're right.
Well done, Susan. Yeah,
well done. Susan.
Now, here are two towns behind me. They both begin with J. Why are they blue?
Oh. Now, I know this.
Yes. But,
well, I know, well, one of them.
Go on, then.
I've got a Smurf collection. I've had it many years. When I was younger, I used to collect Smurfs. It was my hobby. I've got a Smurf village I created when I was younger. It's still there. Reminds me of the bad times. And the good times.
Right.
Now, and if this is wrong, I'm going to look like a total twat.
Yeah. Well, the thing is, you're going to look like a twat even if you're right.
Yeah.
Because knowing this is so deeply sad.
Yes. Yeah, carry on. So I love Smurfs and everything about Smurfs and Smurfette and everything else.
Yeah.
When they did the premiere of the Smurf film,
yes.
They painted a town somewhere, I think it was Spain near Marbella or something like that, blue for the premiere of the film. And then afterwards they said, we'll paint it back. And the residents had had such a lot of tourism and they dubbed the mayor Papa Smurf, which he was delighted about, that they were having a referendum to see if they wanted to keep their town blue because they thought it was quite cool. And I think, because that's Smurf, because it was Smurf Town, which sounds amazing because I love the Smurfs.
You
I like it. It's that
100%
one.
100%
right.
Correct!
Come on! Oh,
wow. What's the worst thing that can happen when you open something?
Well, if it's the gentleman that pressed the button on the Virgin train from Glasgow to London, it says it's seeing me on the toilet, which is what happened to
me. Those doors take so long to open.
Especially if you're a gentleman, you could go, oh, God, if you're a lady, just have a second go. The problem is because I'm so short, my legs were swinging.
I love that you felt you needed to explain that to me. What's the worst thing about Christmas lights?
Oh, they get terribly tangled up,
they do.
Don't they?
The worst thing that I've encountered about Christmas lights is they get in the way of the remote control.
They do interfere with your Wi-Fi.
Yes.
Do they?
Yeah, the microwaves which come from your Wi-Fi router are quite weak and they can get blocked by stronger signals. And indeed, the Christmas lights would be a stronger signal.
The man across the road from me changes my channel on my television.
You must ask him not to sit next to you.
No. He sits across the road and he changes my channel.
Oh, what's in that shape?
He goes...
Highland Games for you.
Road that you can see each other so easily.
You live in a little model village.
I know. Susan Calman from Toy Town.
Stop turning me telly on me, you bastard!
No, you forgot to open the little curtains.
We need to talk about Kevin.
Oh, right.
What can you say about Kevin's?
One of my best friends is called Kevin.
Well, I'm sorry.
The...
I say that because that's a clue as to the answer. I'm sorry
for
him.
Oh, okay. Is it the meaning of the name?
Unfortunately, it's just not a good name to have if you're on the hunt for a partner. On dating websites, people are actively put off by the name Kevin, I'm afraid. Aww. They get fewer replies. So if your name's Kevin, use your middle name. If, but not if your middle name is Marvin, Justin or Dennis, because they're equally unfortunate. It's so unfair. I mean,
I've
you know...
I've never met anyone called
You've never
Kevin.
Met a Kevin?
I've never met a Kevin. I've never met a Kevin.
You've never
Literally
met a Kevin?
Never met a Kevin. Kevin.
There's a Kevin there. You can meet
and
a
we
Kevin.
Believe you. We now
is
believe
someone
you.
Someone called Kevin in.
Susan,
hiya. Kevin.
You've never met a Kevin.
He's gorgeous!
He's lovely, yeah.
Do you know, before tonight, it's like, surprise, surprise. Before tonight, I'd never met a Kevin. Now I'm married to one.
Do
you know
what was meet nice? Your future
you
Kevin.
You were so pleased. You were at last, my time in the sun. It's Kevin!
Sometimes I don't know my own postcode.
You don't it's know just... your postcode?
You know that way your mind works when you get older, that you think of a different postcode where you once lived?
No.
Sometimes you get mixed up.
How do you fare with passwords?
Well, I've got a document called Passwords on my computer. And in that document are all my passwords.
Yes, but presumably your computer is password protected.
Yes, but
so
I
you
know
can't
that
get
one.
Into that
I
document.
I know the password to that one because it's my name. So,
anybody who breaks into your home because you're on QI at the moment just puts your name in and there's a file marked Passwords and you're off and running.
She can't remember where she lives, so I don't
That's
know.
True. Maybe we could get the burglar to ring you and tell you where it is.
This isn't an anagram, it's actually a limerick composed by someone, which I invite you to recite to me.
Oh.
See if you can.
Huh?
Yes. Oh. That's a shock, isn't it?
Yes.
And you can do it.
Can you?
Yep.
Yes, you can. It is a limerick.
Okay. Okay.
Right. Well, you have to ask yourself what these numbers are, in fact. They have
it's
some
a dozen
other...
dozen and 12 dozen.
Ah! We're 12, but 144 is also called a...
gross.
Just keep so, a dozen a gross, a score, plus three times the square root of four, divided by seven, right, so you're doing well, plus 5.0. Calm down, I don't have to slap you.
The QI where Stephen just slapped.
So say it again as a limerick. You okay. can do it now.
Yes, yes.
Go on.
Go on then, Susan.
A dozen a gross and a score, plus three times the square root of four, divided by seven, plus five times 11, equals nine squared, plus not a bit more. There you are. Well done.
Anybody remember the Great Sprout Drought, 2010?
No.
Bad weather, and they went to £9.55 per kilo. There was only 31 pence per kilo cheaper than turkey. So you had to choose.
Is a kilo a lot? Cos I did my home shopping the other day and I ordered one mushroom by mistake. I felt so bad because it arrived in a separate bag. And you can just imagine the guy going up the aisle going...
Did you write one? How many grams
I
did you write?
I thought it was ordering like a packet, so I just put one.
Did you eat the mushroom? I mean, when it came to like making dinner, did you go, well, I'll put the mushroom in?
I ate the mushroom quickly because in the same shopping, I thought I'd ordered four onions and I ordered four sacks of onions. To get rid of the onions before my wife came home.
Yeah.
So I went down the close of my flat offering people bags of onions and pretended it was a Scottish tradition. Oh, it's onion day.
So, did you tell your wife?
No.
Did she watch this show?
Ha!
You can change the channel and say, that'll be the guy over the road. He's always...
Thank you for watching. Do remember to subscribe to the QI channel and click here to watch more videos. please, come on, pick something.